For us, digital transformation is broadly in four pillars. One is modernizing the data center. How do we actually go about modernizing the data center from the legacy hardware data center to move to the software-defined data center? It's about transforming security. Security is a big threat today and a concern for most of the enterprises. How do we actually help the journey of the customer from transforming the security to make sure that that's foolproof? The third part is how do we actually integrate public clouds, right? Today, the most popular ones are AWS and Azure, right? What is our strategy in terms of integrating to that public cloud? And the fourth thing is how do we transform the endpoint management? How do you make the endpoint management access, right? A lot more user-friendly, a lot more customizable, right? So the four pillars put together is what we define as digital transformation. Today, if you look at the on-premise infrastructure that we have at the data center, right, VMware is a leader out there. So we have our virtualization technologies on server, compute, on storage, on network, okay, pretty much prevalent in most of the data centers. So our stated intent last year, and we have that in play today, is basically to integrate with all the three public clouds, right? How can a customer seamlessly move workloads from on-prem infrastructure data center to the public cloud and back? That's the magical portion. Customers can choose to go one way from on-prem to public cloud, but that's a lot of application replatforming, and if the workload needs to come back to on-premise, there's a big challenge out there. So our stated intent is to basically ensure a customer can move his or her workloads from on-premise to the public cloud and back, right? We have SoftLayer in play. We have a customer in Chennai called Mgage, who's actually using SoftLayer to burst out to the public cloud and back. We have announced a partnership with Amazon. We're expecting that to hit India soon. It's there in the US right now. And then obviously we also stated up our intent to partner with Azure to basically do the same effect of moving workloads up and down to the Azure platform. So let's look at some of the key verticals where we have seen digital transformation happen. It's happened in BFSI, it's happening in BFSI. Proof of the pudding is State Bank of India, the largest bank that we have in the country, is transformed the entire private cloud and also transformed the 25,000 branches to move on to the virtual platform and actually make it a lot more agile. So State Bank of India is a great reference point for us in BFSI. If you look at the telecom vertical, Airtel is another great reference that we have. The customer's completely transformed his data center to modernize it to completely being software-defined right now. A software-defined data center with NSX's underlying technology to make sure the security policies are there. If I take education, a great reference that we have in Velour Institute of Technology, the use case there being that students bring their own devices and then hook onto the college network and then they access both the digital library and online labs. How do you actually streamline the entire operation with a software-defined data center as well as endpoint management, right? VIT again is a great example in education. If I look at new age companies, Book My Show is a great example too, right? Book My Show is the largest movie ticket provider and entertainment service provider in the country. So Book My Show has used digital transformation where the IT drives the business outcome. When I say that, today people familiar with Book My Show, you log on to an app, within 3 minutes you actually get a ticket to your mailbox, right? And that's a great story of how IT has transformed transformation. So to answer your question, multiple verticals have multiple different stages of adoption. Pharmaceutical is a key vertical, manufacturing is a key vertical, education is a key vertical, BFSI, government, telecom. We are seeing digital transformation getting adopted across various verticals and in varying degrees. When you say emerging verticals, I mean, we have seen success. I can quote a vertical which is basically not something which is out of the book. So there's a customer called Chitle Dairy in rural Maharashtra, right? The main business is dairy farm. So there are cows which are there around the dairy farm. So Mr. Vishwas Chitle, a great friend of VMware, he went and fitted a RFID on every cow's ears. So what that RFID does is feed that information back to a data center. The analytics run on the data center on the health of the cow, and the information is fed to the farmer in terms of where the farmer needs to focus to basically increase the productivity of the cow, right? There's a great story, we have cows to the cloud, and that's like a classical example on the emerging verticals where technology is transforming. Again, as I said, digital transformation is where IT drives the business outcome. Here is where IT is a great driver of the business outcome, which is productivity of the cows and thereby profitability of the dairy farm. One of the four pillars I mentioned, one of them, the key pillars was transform security. Security today has got multitude of players. If I show the slide of how many players are there in security, it'd be amazing. You won't have space to fit in a slide. There are more than 200 plus players in the security domain. Where we come in with respect to transforming security to the client is basically setting up a platform on which they can run their security architecture. Okay, there's a unified platform, be it security policy, be it micro-segmentation. We have a great product in NSX, which basically sets the platform on which you can actually run a security architecture. It's very important, especially given that it's all about cyber warfare now, and given that a lot of these publicly driven companies like BookMyShow and other companies which are known in the industry coming under a lot of threat on the security, it's very important to form the foundation right. Once you get the foundation right, then you can fit in the solution that fits into the architecture. So absolutely, so we are a heavily channel-oriented company, and our success depends on the channel. And in fact, our success can be attributed to the channel. The channel is a great lever for us. Okay, one of the things we have been working on last year is how do I build a profitable services line in the partner, right? One is the money that the partner makes on channel programs and rebates, but more importantly, how do we develop competencies in the partner, and how do we actually have the partner stand up in confidently in front of the customer and actually talk about and servicing the customer after the sale, right? We are there in the journey. I think we're heading the right track. It's all about building competencies. We are never shy of training our partners. We invest quite a bit in our webinars. We invest quite a bit in hands-on labs with the partners. And also we basically make sure that we are doing a joint business plan with the partner to ensure that services line is one particular component that we call out. Profitability is equal to services, and unless the partner gets the services right, okay, he's not going to be happy with what he does with VMware. And secondly, partner services also ups the competency and the customer satisfaction. The partners able to handle the opportunity in front of the customer in terms of planning and designing and deploying the technology, it brings a lot more repeat business for the partner. So we are disproportionately focused on the services part of it. We definitely want our partners to be standing up on their own feet and driving the solutions to the customers. It's a journey, and we are on the right track on that one.